Harry Potter books, and they really wished there was a world where they were able to go to wizarding school. So we created our very own wizarding school where we use science to bring the world to life. So we are going to show you today some of the things we do. This is just a sampling of experiments that you might do in our wizarding camps. We actually have three different wizarding camps that have all different experiments in them. But today we're going to be doing, the first thing we're going to do that you can do at home is you're going to be making, going to a potions class where you're going to be making your very own bouncing crystal ball. Then you're going to be doing some potioneering with Dr. Ed and seeing some things that we do in the space here. And then finally, we're going to be having a challenge where you are going to think about, there's so many different creatures in the Harry Potter world. We are going to use genetics to breed our very own pygmy pups.
One of the first things you're going to learn is the properties of your breath. In here, we have a beaker full of water, and we have two different solutions. What do you guys think this is? I think most people would say food coloring. So we're going to add this to our liquid. What color do you notice that it turned into? You'll see that it has a nice greenish hue. And using my wand, I'm going to stir the liquid, and we're going to add this second clear liquid to this green solution. And most likely it should turn a lighter green. Okay. As we add it in, what do we notice is happening? Well, it's actually turned a purplish color. And now we're going to do a special spell using your breath. So we have been able to capture your breath. And I know a lot of you guys already know what this is. You guys say dry ice. But do you know what dry ice is made out of? So I want everyone to collectively breathe in and breathe out. And what you breathe out was carbon dioxide. And what we did was we froze your carbon dioxide from all around the world and made it into this block of dry ice. And it's so cold that it's causing the water in the air to condense, and that's why you see these vapors. So we're going to add your breath to our beaker filled with this purple solution. And let's see what happens. But before that, we're going to do the spell, Colobaria. And see what that spell actually does. So if you look closely, you'll notice that your beaker is actually turning colors. So what's happening is that this, which we thought was food coloring, is actually a universal indicator. So it detects the pH of a liquid. And what we added here was a strong base. This is sodium hydroxide, which is in the second clear liquid. So initially the water was neutral, which is why it turned green with the universal indicator. And then when we added the sodium hydroxide, it turned purple, which became more basic. And then when we added the dry ice, which is made of carbon dioxide, it reacts with water to form what's known as carbonic acid, and it's making the liquid more acidic. And that's why it turned from purple to green, blue, and then now it's going from orange, and it'll go all the way down to red. We have a big metal bowl, and we have a block of dry ice, or your breath, frozen. We're gonna add it in. And then we're gonna pour in some hot water.
Wow!
And we have this magical rag that we received from this amazing place. It's in the jungles of the Amazon, and it came in 2 days. And what we're going to do is we're going to say the spell Inflatus, and let's see what happens if we say the spell Inflatus. what we have is a bubble forming with all the gas that's being produced from the dry ice, and as well as the air that was already in there. And what we have is a layer of water that's sandwiched in between two layers of soap. And as the water evaporates, the bubble will eventually cease to exist. We can make the bubble dance by blowing on it.
I did that.
Yeah. So my little first year student is showing how the bubble is dancing. Oh, amazing. So could I have my little assistant come up, and you're gonna hold your hands out like this. Okay, come up and put your hands together like this. And then we're gonna see if you could hold.
It's big. I pop.
This is how we wash our hands at Wizarding School. We have our frozen breath and hot water.
Let us know if there are any new things you come up with and share with us on our Facebook page. We're always adding new videos every week, things that you can do at home or even in your own classroom. Make sure to like our video, share, and subscribe to our channel.